Hello friends, in the last lecture we have seen downsampling. So we have seen that a spectrum of input signal and what happens to it when we downsample the signal. We have seen that suppose I have drawn the same spectrum which is having input signal is having high frequency which is pi by 3, and if you want to downsample this signal by a factor of 3, what happens? The signal amplitude gets compressed and the signal is spread by a factor of 3. So what will happen to this signal? Pi by 3 into 3, that is equal to pi. So this point will move on to this point, and this amplitude is 1 by 3. Suppose it is 1, then it is 1 by 3. So what happens? This spreads. And we have seen how to draw the shifted images. So these were placed around 2 pi minus 2 pi like this. So I am drawing shorter spectrum at this time because we have seen how to draw the spread. So the signal spread like this. So we have seen that when the signal is band limited to pi by 3, now this point is going up to pi. If this frequency is somewhat larger than pi by 3, then what will happen? Okay, so we'll see what happens if this is larger than pi by 3 in case of downsampling by a factor of 3. Okay, so let us draw a signal. So we have to draw the images also, because originally sampled signal means discrete time signal is having images in its spectrum. So let us say instead of pi by 3, we'll take pi by 2. So this point is suppose comes here, pi by 2. I am not drawing to the scale. So these images also will be somewhat larger. And its amplitude is 1, say. So what will happen to the spectrum? Now we have to calculate the new frequency up to which this will go, the spread of this original spectrum. So pi by 3, pi by 2 into downsampling factor 3. So this will become 3 pi by 2. So it is 3 by 2 pi means 1 which is more than pi. So say amplitude will be the same, and this will go ahead of this pi point. So its images also will cross that point pi, and it will be like this. Okay. So from this point to this point, whatever is happening, we call it aliasing. So it is because of the mixing of this spectrum and its images. So in frequency, when we are using the low pass filter, we'll get like this. This spectrum will add up with each other and we'll get a spectrum like this. So actually this problem is not from this point to this point. The problem is occurring from this point to this point. So the spectrum will be like this. And when we use a low pass filter, we'll get a shape. We are using low pass filter for reconstruction. So it will be like this low pass filter. And we'll get a shape of the signal like this. So this shape will not be like this. This is like at from this point onwards, the tilt will start like this. Okay, so we'll get a shape like this, and our original shape was like triangular. So whatever shape it was, it is getting modified because of this mixing at every point. Okay, so this is aliasing, which is happening because of downsampling. And we can see that the highest frequency present in the signal and downsampling factor is somehow related. So you can downsample this signal, which is having high frequency pi by 2, by a factor of 2 very easily without aliasing. So that signal will go up to pi only. So no mixing will be there. Okay. So we can actually find a relationship. So we can say a signal with higher frequency pi by 3 can be downsampled by a factor of 3. A signal with higher frequency pi by 2 can be downsampled by a factor of 2. Okay. So we can see that a signal must be band limited to a certain frequency. So downsampling by a factor of 3, the signal should be band limited to pi by 3. And by downsampling by a factor of 2, the signal must be limited to pi by 2. Or it can work if the signal is also of pi by 3. But cut to cut, we can think of pi by 2. Okay. So we can relate this to downsampling by a factor of m. The signal must be band limited to this, pi by m. So for downsampling such signals, we have to use a low pass filter which will band limit the signal to the required frequency. Okay. So here downsampling by a factor of 3 we want. So we must limit the signal to pi by 3. So for that, we will use a anti-aliasing filter, we call this. This is low pass filter which is having gain 1 and the cutoff frequency which is equal to pi by 3. So we have to repeat this at 2 pi, at minus 2 pi and so on. So passing the signal spectrum through this h of e raised to j omega, this is your h of e raised to j omega, your signal will be modified like this. So it will be limited to pi by 3. So everywhere this kind of shape is repeated. So we are actually limiting the signal, we are cutting off some part of the signal, because mixing is not done. If we spread this signal pi by 3, it will go up to only pi. So let us draw that downsampled spectrum. So this will be 1 by 3 compressed amplitude if we are downsampling by a factor of 3. So this pi by 3 will spread up to only pi, this point. And on this side, it will spread up to minus pi only. So this will be like, okay. And this will be spread. Actually, this is not spread. This is shifted version. So we can draw this like, so this is at minus 2 pi, minus 2 pi this point. Okay. So at least in this case, we are not getting the mixture of the original spectrum and its images. So whatever the problem was occurring, starting at some point before pi and after pi, so that problem is not occurring when we are band limiting the signal with the help of this low pass filter, which is also called as anti-aliasing filter. So because of this, aliasing is not occurring. At least we can reconstruct this part of signal which was up to the highest frequency pi by 3. So to some extent this problem is solved. So let us draw. This whole process is called as decimation. Decimation is downsampling with low pass filtering done before the downsampling. So let us draw this, how the decimation process is actually working. So I'll draw the block diagram. We are giving x of n, we want to downsample this signal. So we are passing it through a filter, which is a low pass filter, okay, which is having gain is equal to 1 and the cutoff frequency is equal to pi by m. So pi by m, this m is the down sampling factor, and after that we are down sampling the signal with the down sampling factor m, and we are getting the output signal y of n. So somehow with using this h of e raised to j omega, we are getting rid of this aliasing which is happening if we are directly going for the downsampling of the signal. So if this downsampling factor and the higher frequency in the signal are properly related to each other, then that in that case aliasing is not occurring in the spectrum. But if this relationship is not maintained, then we have to use a low pass filter, which is also called as anti-aliasing filter. Thank you.